Hi friends, in today's video I am going to teach you how to draw realistic hair using colored pencils. Before starting the tutorial, I will show you the drawing I have done. This is the one and it is yet to complete. Anyway, let's get started with the tutorial. Before I get into the process, here I want to start with few basic tips to get the realistic look. First of all, to get the accurate sketch is very important whenever you are trying to draw realistic. You get the outline by using any method like grid lines or freehand, like whichever you are comfortable, you use that method and you first get the accurate sketch. It is better to have very light sketch and it doesn't have to be much detailed. You just have to mark the direction of the hair and shadows and the highlights of the hair. Once you are done with the accurate sketch, then differentiate between the shadows and highlights. Wherever the shadows are there, you better mark it with some dark color pencil. Then it will be easier for further drawing. And whenever you are drawing hair, it is better to use linear strokes. Whenever we are drawing skin, we are used to use circular strokes, but whenever we are drawing hair, it is better to use linear strokes. It gives that flowy texture to the hair. You just mark the direction of the hair and the shapes and clumps of the hair differently. You don't have to mark every tiny single hair in the clumps. You can just concentrate on the direction of the hair and the clumps of the hair. And whenever you are drawing hair, you must keep your pencil very sharp. Otherwise, the drawing doesn't look neat. These are the basic tips to start any realistic hair drawing. Now I'll get into the process. Here, what I did, I have applied thin layer of soft pastel before using the color pencils. This makes me easier to fill largest areas before getting into the details. What happens whenever I am using color pencil, the white grain of the paper is showing through the pencil strokes. So to avoid that, I'll apply thin layer of soft pencil before. So it will cover the white paper evenly. So whenever I apply color pencil, the white grain of the paper is minimized. Whenever I am drawing hair, I don't like to use black directly to the hair. It will make my drawing look flattened. So you cannot get realistic look only by using black. So I am using different colors here. First of all, wherever the shadows are there, I am marking it up with dark blue. And during the initial sketch, it is important to get the shapes and direction of the hair correct. You observe the flow of hair, in which direction it is flowing. make the shapes accordingly. Remember to keep your pencil sharp while drawing. I don't say this is the only method to draw hair, but this is what I am using. And if you find some other method better than this, then you can go ahead. First, black in the darkest areas first. That makes me easier to find out the difference between shadows and highlights. So initially I am making these shapes, and this is not going to be the final look of my drawing. Still, I'll have to apply many layers upon this. This is just the basic shape I am giving here. I am using makeup brush to apply the soft pastel. You can use any kind of soft pastel to get that initial layer. Here I am using Sennelier soft pastel sticks. If you want to know the materials what I am using, I will add them in the description along with the Amazon affiliate links. You can directly purchase from that link. See, the soft pastels are really good to cover the largest areas very soon. So I use them for initial layer of my drawings. However, I cannot get realistic look by using only soft pastels, so I'll have to apply in many layers with pencils. I am using some reddish brown here to get the shadows. If I use only black alone, it does not look realistic. If you observe the hair, it is not pure black. It has many shades in it. So you will have to apply undertone before applying the black. So whenever you are drawing a realistic drawing, you need to work in several layers. Be patient, observe the reference photo carefully, and don't rush. This color pencil is not a fast medium. It actually takes time than what you have imagined. It actually takes more time than what you have imagined. So be patient while working. Apply as many layers as possible. And whenever you are applying initial layers, don't apply more pressure. If you are applying more pressure during the initial layers, then it will fill up the gaps between the paper and you cannot apply any more layers upon that. So initially you work with less pressure with your strokes. Whenever you are done with the layers, then you can blend it up by using more pressure. I am using reddish brown pencil here. For the highlights of the hair, I am using golden yellow. And for shadows, blue, black, and reddish brown. And whenever I am doing a portrait drawing, I don't like to finish up any single part and then jump into the other parts. I like to work it as in layers. That means I will apply thin layer over all the portrait, then I will go for another layers. This helps me to get uniform look. If I finish off the any single part like nose, eyes or lips or something, if I have to match the skin tone with other parts, then it will be difficult. By that time I would have forgotten which color pencil I had used to the particular part. So I choose to work in layers. Whenever I am applying one particular color, I will apply overall the portrait wherever it is required, so that I will not forget which pencil I have used. Initially, when I started color pencil drawings, I did that mistake that I used to finish off one particular part in the portrait, then whenever I jump into the next portrait, then I would have forgotten which pencil I have used during that time. So I work in the layers. It makes me easier to get uniformity. If you observe the portrait, near the face there is a shadow, so hair is looking darker over there. So there I'll have to apply black color, otherwise it doesn't give that shadow look. For other parts of the hair, other flowy parts of the hair, I am not using that much black as I am using near the face. Wherever the shadows are there, you cannot see any details. So that is pitch black in color. If you want to know what all the materials I am using, like which color pencils and which pastel colors I am using, I will add the link in the description. You can directly buy them from Amazon. You just enjoy the process. Here I think I don't have much to say. You just observe how I am drawing. And if you have any doubts, please comment below. I will try to answer each and every one of them. See, I am applying in many layers. I am using brown color, reddish brown color, yellow, blue, and dark brown and black color here. You must show the differentiation between shadows and highlights. Then it gives that shine of the hair. see at the top, I found it was looking flat, so I was applying this reddish brown color over there. It gives little shine to the hair. Observe more when you are drawing and go with the flow. When you are observing, you will get many ideas what to do. So you just follow that and don't be in doubt or in fear that you are going to ruin the drawing. You have to experiment with your methods. Who knows, you may get better version. Now it is started looking bit realistic, right? When you had applied only few layers, hair was looking loose and in grayish color. When you started adding brown and black color, it started looking thick. And this small flyaway hairs are very important to make your drawing look realistic. If you observe carefully, hair does not have any proper border. Like only till here you'll have to shade and then you shouldn't leave like that. There are small teeny flyaway hairs. So you will have to add those details with sharp pencils. Here I am using Prismacolor pencils. These are wax based pencils. When I am working with these wax pencils, it gives little wax on the paper that you will have to clean it up by using painting brush in between. If you try to clean it with your hands, it may smudge and gives dirty look. So better you use painting brushes to wipe off the extra wax built on the paper. Hope you are finding this video useful. If so, please subscribe to my channel. You will be seeing more such art videos in my channel. You may find all of them useful. If you have any suggestions, please comment below. I would like to hear all of them. If you want to see more of my drawings, I am active in Instagram. Please follow my Instagram account. Link is in the description. If you are using any other method for hair drawing and if you find that is very useful, then please share with me also. I would like to have a look at it. fill up the gaps in between during the final stage of the drawing. Only highlight parts of the hair should be light, otherwise you need to fill all the gaps. This video is longer than other videos of mine. I thought if it is like this, it will be easier for someone to learn. So I didn't fasten it so much so that you can see my pencil strokes. If you want to practice, I think this will be helpful to you. Even by watching the video, you can practice it. During video also, you can start drawing. If you want me to make shorter videos, then let me know. Again, I am saying, work patiently when you are drawing. Don't just try to finish it off early. If you do so, your drawing may look unfinished and not realistic. Initially, I used to feel drawing hair used to be the most challenging part of the portrait. But after practice, I found out drawing hair is really fun. I find it very interesting. So, after seeing this video, you also try to draw like this. And tag Lavanya's art tutorial. I will share them in my Instagram stories. Hope you are finding it useful. You should pay attention to direction of the hair and the shadows and highlights. If the direction and shadows and highlights are correct, then it almost looks realistic. Rest depends on your shading techniques. Again, I am telling you, when you are drawing hair, use linear strokes. Avoid using circular strokes. This is almost done. Only a little is remaining. I think by now you understood the whole process of hair drying. Hope you liked it. If so, let me know in the comments. If you don't like it also, you just let me know. I will try to improve. adding those tiny flyaway hair details at the end. This brings realistic look to the hair. You observe more, you will understand better. See, this flyaway hair should not be very dark, so I am using lighter pencils here. And I am wiping off the extra pencil using kneaded eraser. And this is extractor knife. I use this extractor knife to pull out the tiny details. Thanks for watching complete video. Hope you have found it useful. If so, please subscribe to my channel. I'll be making more such art videos every week in this channel. And this is the second video of color pencil series. If you haven't watched first video, please watch the first one. Link is in the description. Thank you. Take care.